Hey guys, Peter here once again to talk about my favorite 5 albums for the month of August. I look forward to this video every month to share my top picks with all of you because I also get to see what you guys consider your top picks in the comment section below. So use that comment section wisely. Let me know your thoughts on your own picks, on my picks. That's exactly the point of this video, is for us to share notes and perhaps expand our knowledge and our discography on a month by month basis. But let's get into this list. We're gonna go through it chronological order based on the date of release, starting off with Soulfly Totem out August 5th on Nuclear Blast. This is the band's 12th studio record. They are a death metal band. I mean, that's what this album is. This is a death metal record, old school death metal record. I love this album. I was shocked and surprised with how raw, how aggressive, how intensive this record is. I was expecting perhaps a little bit more of the tribal ritual sound that you normally get on a Soulfly record. I was not expecting them to go almost 100% old school death metal, but I'm glad they did. The album delivers across each and every single song. One of the most complete, most balanced records that the band has ever released. Definitely one of my favorites. I just love the sound. I love this experience. Max sounded phenomenal on this record, going back to those early Sepultura days, and that is always a great thing. Anytime you can reminisce about the past, about the great genre of death metal, about all the bands that trailblazed that genre, and then you hear Max sing on a record like that, and it takes you back into that time period, the album is always going to be a winner, and that's exactly what Soulfly did with Totem. Next, we have Seven Storm with Maledictus out August 12th on Atomic Fire Records. This is the band's debut record. They are a gothic metal band, and what a debut record this is. The album is really interesting because it creates sound, experience, vocal performance, all of these elements coming together in order to create an incredible atmosphere that is very particular to them. This album from the get-go sets exactly what the DNA of this band is going to be all about. When you listen to this album, you're going to identify with the sound and you're always going to know you're listening to Seven Storm. Very hard to do that on a debut record. Normally on a debut album, the band is still trying to find themselves. They're still trying to figure out exactly who they are and what they want to do. This record comes in very well shaped, very well tooled. It doesn't feel like a debut album. It feels like an album from a seasoned band. They have also a phenomenal vocalist that delivers across every single track. It has great tone, great delivery, great vocals. He is the voice of the sound, of the experience, of the atmosphere, of the band, and of this record. Next, you have the Halo Effect, Days of the Lost, out August 12th on Nuclear Blast.
I don't want.
This is also a debut record, and they are a melodic death metal band, and what a debut record it is. But this is a little bit different because the expectations with this one were a little bit higher, because you could look at this band and say, well, it's a debut record, but they are a super group. I mean, this band is made up of members of other bands from Dark Tranquillity to In Flames. These guys know exactly what they're doing. They know exactly what they want to do. And this album is flawless from start to finish. Within the genre of melodic death metal, it's going to be very hard to find an album better than this one this year. And this is a debut. So sky is the limit as far as the halo effect is concerned. This album has a great sonic experience. It has a great guitar sound. It has an incredible vocalist behind it that knows how to deliver the best and to get the best out of the sound that's been created behind him. This record is for the ages, an album that everybody had been looking forward to it for a very long time. And when it came in, it did not disappoint a single soul. Magnificent record by the Halo Effect. Next, we have Arch Enemy with Deceivers, out August 12th on Century Media Records. This is the band's 12th studio album. They are a melodic death metal band, and I really enjoyed this record. Now, don't come in expecting this album to be what previous records were. I mean, if you want to listen to a previous record from Arch Enemy, those records are still there. You can still go listen to them. But I enjoy the fact that this band is trying to move forward without necessarily changing their DNA overnight. They're infusing a few pieces with every passing album. With every passing album, they add something new. On this record, for example, clean vocals, something I was not expecting until I heard, obviously, the singles. But once I heard the singles, then my expectations grew. And if there's one thing I would change about this album, I wanted more clean vocals. I think there was room for it. I think it would have a positive impact in the experience, in the overall design, and how the album could come across. But outside of that, this is a very strong album by Arch Enemy. I enjoy this record fully from beginning to end. It's an album that has a great guitar sound. It has great solos. Alyssa's perhaps at her best on this album vocally. Her range is finally coming into the zone, and she's comfortable enough to really showcase everything, every single tool that she has on her arsenal. But it's also an album that has this feel to it. It has a little bit of an aura to it. So a magnificent album by Arch Enemy. I really enjoy it. It's full of hooks. It's full of catchy choruses. It's an album that's built around earworms. Every song could be a single. I know that's a cliche, but on this record, it really feels that way. It's a great balanced record. It's a great strong record from this incredible band. Last but not least, we have Machine Head of Kingdom and Crown, out August 26th on Nuclear Blast.
Society lost in vanity, paid to slowly die. Life is the prepared soul, incarcerate, cut in like a knife. Shoving their vile venom down our throats like on a pen. Force feed their lies back like medicine. Show on the ashes of your rage. It's not too late.
This is the band's 10th studio album, and they are a groove metal band. And this record could easily be their best album to date. It's going to be very hard for me to say that because Burn My Eyes is still my favorite Machine Head album of all time. But this album is very close to it. It's perhaps neck and neck with that record. So it's a phenomenal album from Machine Head. An album that Machine Head really needed, considering how disappointed the previous album was to most fans out there, myself included. So I wanted a rebound album. I wanted an album that had groove, that had great sound, that perhaps had the roots of what Machine Head was all about. And this album does all of that. And then to add to that, it's a concept record, the first time that they're doing a concept record. So you're never really sure how that's going to go, but everything was at the right place at the right time. This is a phenomenal album, an album for the ages, an album that in my opinion is going to be in a lot of people's top list for best album of the year. And having said that, this month of August, how many albums out of this month of August are going to be in the top five albums of the year come December? I think a lot of them. This is a packed month. This list is packed with great records, and Machine Head, to close it off, I think it's the best album to close this list because it puts the exclamation mark on it. This is it, guys. Let me know your thoughts on my list, on your list. Use the comment section below. We'll see you guys at the next video.